Hello guys, welcome to Think IoT Solutions. So in this particular tutorial we'll be looking at 2D images, basics of image processing, and what are the pixel values in an image and so on. So first let me just explain about what is an image consist of. So basically we are looking at a 2D image for this particular tutorial. So 2D image is something which has two dimensions, that is X and Y. So if you can see this figure, you'll understand that we have two dimensions. One is X dimension and one is a Y dimension. Let's say for example, in X dimension you have got 512 pixels. In Y dimension also you have got 512 pixels. So a pixel is something which is a minimum measurable quantity in an image. That is, an image is made up of many pixels. In this case, the image is made up of 512 by 512 pixels. That is, in the X direction you have 512 pixels, in the Y direction also you have 512 pixels. That is why it is called as a 2D image. It has got two dimensions, that is X and Y. So the smallest entity in a particular image, as it is shown here in blue color, it is called as a pixel. So that is the unit of measurement for an image. So now coming back to this particular page. So as I mentioned, that image consists of pixels, and as an example I said a 512 by 512 image will have 512 pixels in X direction and 512 pixels in Y direction. So a pixel occupies 1 byte of memory. That is, as you know, 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, and if you make a 2 power 8 then it will come to 256. That is, the maximum that a pixel value can have is 0 to 255. So 0 being the least particular number, and that is represented by black, and 255 being the highest, which is represented by white. So let's say if you have a black and white image, then it will have only two pixel values, that is 0 or 255. So 0 being that particular pixel is a black pixel, and 255 being that particular pixel is a white pixel. So if you have any other values apart from 0 and 255, then those values fall in the region of gray color. So therefore, if you have any pixel values like 170 or 180 or 200, then it will have different shades of gray, as we will see in this particular tutorial. So with this basics in mind, let us go to our Google Colab. So in the last tutorial, we have seen the basics of how to install your G Drive onto your Google Colab, and then we have seen one or two programs in it, that is how to read and write the file. So we'll be continuing on the same page, that is the same notebook in Google Colab, and this is the first small particular code cell that we have. So here I'm discussing with a module called as NumPy. So basically a module is something which has got lot of inbuilt functions in Python, which you can import and with which you can use those functions in your existing code. So I'm importing this module called NumPy, that is NumPy. So basically this NumPy module is used to make the array operations easier. That is, any mathematical and logical array operations are there, those operations can be done very easily using a NumPy module. So therefore I'm importing the NumPy module, and I'm importing as a smaller name, that is NP, so that I can use this NP in my entire program from now on instead of using a bigger name. So I'm importing NumPy as NP. So I have just written a small program here. So what this program does is, I'll just execute it so that you'll understand. So I'm running on the code cell. So you can see the result here. So I'm saving the first particular array like this, that is 1 comma 2 comma 3 in one square bracket, and then I'm giving a comma and 4 5 6 in another square bracket. Whereas in the second case, I'm storing 1 2 in one square bracket, 3 4 in one, and 5 6 in one. So you see how it creates. So in the first case, this particular 1 2 3 is one row of a matrix, and 4, 5, 6 is another row of a matrix. So basically this particular representation like this is going to create me a matrix of size 2, 3, as you can see here. So this is the particular result of this line that I have shown here. So size of the matrix is 2, 3. So what I'm doing is, I'm creating two variables A and B, I'm storing two arrays and I'm printing those. So in the first line I'm saying matrix values and I'm printing that variable A. In the second line I'm saying size of that matrix and I'm using a function called shape. So I'm saying A dot shape, so it will give me the size of that particular matrix. In the second case I'm printing B and I'm using here B dot shape, which will give me the size of B matrix. So the A matrix size is 2 by 3 because I'm creating it as 2 rows and 3 columns. But in the second case, as you can see, I have given square brackets for 1 and 2, for 3 and 4, and for 5 and 6. So 1 and 2 will form one row, 3 and 4 will form another row, and 5 and 6 will form another row. So in this particular array, that is in the B matrix, the shape will be 3 by 2. Why? Because I will be having 3 rows and 2 columns. So that is how easy it is for for us to use the NumPy. So after having understood this, you can just try with the different combinations in your Google Colab and see how the results are. You can just print that particular shape by using A dot shape, that is a rows and columns of that particular matrix. So you can create different types of arrays using NumPy. So after this particular example, I'll just show a basic operations in OpenCV. So OpenCV is basically, it's a computer vision application wherein you can read, write images, you can process the images, you can do some very interesting applications using OpenCV. That is, you can detect a particular object based on color. That is, if you want to only pick red color from your image, you can do that. If you want to pick only green color from your image, you can do that. So that is based on the color segmentation. So that way you can do many applications using OpenCV. So we'll be discussing all those in details, but before that, only for this tutorial, we'll be going on with the basic image reading operation and image showing operation. So I'm importing a module called CV2, that is CV2 represents OpenCV. So I'm just saying import CV2. Again, I'm importing NumPy as NP, same. And I'm importing a function called as CV2 underscore IM show. So I'll tell you why I'm importing this particular function here after this particular program is executed. So then what I'm doing is I'm using a function called CV2.imread, as you can see here. So imread is a function which is used to read an image. So CV2 is the module that I have imported here. So CV2.imread is going to read an image which is present in this directory. So what is this directory? As I have already mounted my G drive, the directory is my Google Drive directory, which is Colab Notebooks, and it is saying image2.jpg. So let me just show you that image before itself, so that once we see the result, we'll understand. So image2.jpg is this. So this is that image that I have stored in my Google Drive. So I'm going to access that image. And whatever this particular line is reading, I'm storing that data into a variable called img. So img is my variable in which I'm storing that particular image data. And I'm using this function that I have imported, cv2 underscore imshow here. So you can see I have said cv2 underscore imshow of this particular image, whatever image that I am reading. So that is stored in a variable called img. So therefore I'm writing that particular image here, that is img, right? So okay, so I'll just show that image. So I'll run this code. So you can see that as soon as I've executed the code, you can see the output here. That is, whatever image I have shown from my Google Drive, that image you can see here because I have written this function CV2 underscore IM show of IMG. So basically this IMG is nothing but the image data that we are reading. Now, for your understanding, I'm also printing img.shape. So when I'm printing img.shape, you can see that it is showing just below the image a value called 256,256. So this image has got 256 pixels on the x side and 256 pixels in the y dimension. So therefore it is printing 256,256 here. So this particular image has got 256 pixels on X and 256 pixels on Y, and it is a gray image. That is, it is a 2D image wherein the values can range from 0 to 255, 0 being black and 255 being white, and all the other values which are not black and white, they can go in the form of a gray, and that is shown in this particular image. So my next code will clear your understanding even further on these images. So what I'm doing here is I'm using the NumPy library and module, and I am creating a particular image so that you can understand clearly. So what I'm doing is I'm taking a variable img, and I am saying np.ones 256 comma 256 and np uint 8. So let me explain this. So basically I am creating an array of 256 by 256 dimension, that is 256 in x and 256 in y, and I'm using a data type called uint 8, that is unsigned int of 8 bits. So because the image pixel will be having a value from 0 to 255, that is, it is a 1 byte pixel, so therefore I'm using a data type called uint 8, and I'm storing that particular whole array into a particular variable called img. So this particular line will store all ones, that is 256 cross 256, but each element will have a 1 in its particular entry, right? So you can see here it is showing return a new array of given shape and type filled with ones. So each and every element of array will be having a 1 in its place, and like this I am creating 256 by 256 array. Now I am just creating a variable called black. And as you know, black is nothing but a pixel value which is having a 0. So I am creating np.zeros. So you can see here np.zeros, it's a built-in function which will put zeros in all the places. And I am creating 128 by 128 here. Again, I am using the same data type, uint 8. Then that is, I am creating a black variable. Then I am creating a variable called white. And now I'm using 255 into np.ones. So because I'm using 255 into 1 means all entries of this particular matrix, that is 128.128, will become 255 because I'm multiplying 1 by 255. Then I'm using gray one, wherein I'm multiplying all the ones by 100, so all the matrix will become 100. Gray 2, I'm using 200 as a multiplier. And as you can see, each array in these four types is 128 by 128. That is, I want to create four matrices of 128 by 128 and I want to put them side by side. So now what I'm doing is, as you can see here, I'm using img, that is this variable, img of 0 colon 128, 0 colon 128. That is, I'm taking the first quadrant of that particular image and I'm making it black. Then I'm taking the second quadrant, I'm making it white. That is, I'm saying image of 1 colon 128 comma 128 colon 256 to white. Then I'm taking the third quadrant, 128 colon 256 comma colon 0 colon 128. That is, I'm initializing with gray one. So gray one here, you can see that it is a pixel value of 100 and gray two is a pixel value of 200. Black is nothing but which has pixel values 0, white has pixel values of 255. So once I execute this, you'll understand clearly what I'm doing here. So once, let me just run it. So you can see it is just saying displaying the image, because I'm printing here, displaying the image, that line it is printing here. And you can see it has created four small boxes of 128 by 128. So here you have got a white box, because the background is also white, you are not able to distinguish it, but you have got a white square here, you have got a black square here, you have got a gray square here and another gray square here. So these two gray squares are gray one and gray two. This is a black and this is white. Is that okay? So I hope you understood this. That is, I'm just using some array operations in Python language. And with those array operations, I am filling a 256 by 256 matrix with four different 128 by 128 matrices, that is, as you can see here. And those four matrices are black, white, gray 1 and gray 2. And those four I am filling here, and the result is something like this. So I just wanted to create an image so that you will know what is the difference between black, white and gray. So based on these pixel values, you will have a different output. So just as an example, instead of 100, I will go for 50 and I'll run it. So you can see that now the shade will be little different than earlier. So you will see that this shade has become little dark, right? So if I want to change a little bit, so I'll make this instead of 200, I'll make it as 220. So you can see that the shade in this particular block will become more lighter. So I'll run it. So you can see that it has become little light. So you can just go little more above, like a 240, right? So it has become more lighter. So as your pixel values move closer to 255, you can see that the shade turns to white, and as your pixel values move closer to 0, you can see that the shade turns black. So you can see that this pixel in this particular block, the shade is closer to black because your value is 50. So if you move closer to white, the shade will become lighter. So let's say you go for a 220, then I'll just keep it like this. Now you run it. So you see that the shade will become lighter. So now I think you understood how the pixel values are changing in a particular image. Then the last sentence I have written here, which says cm2.imwrite, that is image write. So I want to write this particular image onto the disk. So I have given a link. So that is the same link of my G drive, and the file name is a_out.jpg. So whenever, now as I have executed this particular code, if we can go and see in the drive, we will be seeing this image with the name a_out.jpg. So let us see that. So this is the a_out.jpg. As you can see now that this image is having four distinguished gray levels. One is a black, one is a white, and these two are the gray shades in a particular image. So in the next session, we will start working on the color images. Thank you.